To be honest, it's not everybody that has 10,000, 100k followers that have purchasing power. A lot of them are just, hey, slay mama, hey, slay you, slay this today, you slay this tomorrow. As long as you, as a content creator, you know, have a relationship with people, they trust you, you bring something, they'll buy it. Don't joke with your subscribers, don't joke with your tribe, because those are the people that actually help you speak up in public.
Who is an influencer? Categorizing influencers based on their reach. How to position or market yourself as an influencer. The types of partnerships or types of work influencers do. The ways content creators make money. How to approach brands. How to act when approached by brands as a micro-influencer. And a few other creative tips. These are the topics we're going to cover in this video, as well as unboxing the PR products I recently got. If this is something that interests you, sit back, relax and enjoy.
Hi guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Stephanie and I'm a London-based content creator. If this is your first time here, please click the subscribe button and the bell right beside it so you get notifications every time I post. While you're watching now, everyone, please click the thumb up button. If this is not your first time here, welcome. I really appreciate your coming back to watch my videos. An influencer basically is someone who has the power to affect the purchasing decisions of people based on their authority, knowledge, position and relationships with their followers. Most of the time, influencers work in a certain niche. If you're not a celebrity, usually you'd have a distinct niche which people who follow you trust your opinions and advice on that. So influencers fall into different categories based on the amount of followers. Unfortunately, micro influencer I'll define as someone who has about 1,000 subscribers on whatever platform it is you're creating from, to about 10,000 or even 20,000, or sometimes, to be honest, 30,000, because the way things are going these days, followers are not even that important. And but I wouldn't say anything less than 1,000, to be honest, because usually just about 5 or 2% of people who buy something you advise them to buy. So you can imagine having less than 1,000, you might not really be able to make anything for the client you're working for or whatever it is you're pushing. But yeah, that 1,000 just kind of solidifies, you know, your grounds. And okay, yes, this person is creating content, this person is known for doing this particular thing, and then there are about 1,000 people following them, sometimes both included. So next thing is how to position or market yourself as an influencer. It's know your niche. As I mentioned in the introduction, if you're not a celebrity, celebrity's girlfriend, celebrity's family member, or just not known for something, or maybe you're acting before, you know, you're someone who actually came out to content create, you should have a niche. Is your niche can be two or three things, it wasn't be one, but it's always good to have something just so that when people think about a certain particular genre, they're remembering you, chica. But if you're just all over the place, you'll just be people just remember you when, you know, they just miss you or something like that, if you get what I mean. So be consistent with your doings, your posting, and then your aesthetics. When consistency, like, this is not far-fetched, consistency is so important in everything we do in life. Even you being the creative, being consistent even helps you get better at what you're doing. Just people just seeing sometimes the fact that someone is doing something over and over again, it kind of solidifies you in their mind. It makes them feel you are a serious person. And the aesthetics, which is like the beauty of your platform or however you create your content, is really, really important, because that's kind of like the first impression. That's kind of like your CV when people see you for the first time and decide, okay, should I actually check what this person is doing or not? The third one is to stay true to your voice. So I know it's easy to get carried away with so many things happening, but just have a way you do things and stick to it. You should change things up if you think, you know, there's better ways of doing what you're doing, but it should be, sometimes you'd be on Instagram, for example, and see a post. Before you even look at the person who posted, you already know who puts it there. Before you read the caption, you already see the name. But there's some kind of things that you just see, or captions you read, you know where it's coming from, you know what the person stands for. Try to know your voice and stick to it. Have an idea of how you want the people who follow you to feel. So these people who follow you, your followers, are your bosses. I know when you're creating content, you think, I don't have a 9-to-5, I don't have a boss, I'm not attending to no one. No, your bosses are your followers, your bosses are your subscribers, your bosses are your buyers. Your client is that contractor that comes, you know, to give you guys a job at the office and stuff like that. But the people who you should take most importantly are the people who follow you, your fans. Those are the most loyal people who always have an idea of how you want them to feel when they see your post, when they see your content, just so that you know how to serve them. Another way of trying to know, you know, how you want them to feel is even asking for feedback when things happen, or just reading your comments, having conversations, engaging. You would get to know how they are feeling, and then you confirm if that is how you want them to feel about the content you're creating. And last but not the least, your uniqueness. Capitalize on whatever it is that makes you different. Everybody is different. You can't try to be like someone. You can look at someone, maybe the way the person is so consistent and you want to emulate that, the way the person is so creative with colors and you want to emulate that, things like that, yes. But do not forget that you are you for a reason. There's no one else that can be a better you. So always try to work to improve yourself from what you were the day before than trying to emulate someone, trying to copy someone. You just look really, really foolish copying people. Just be yourself. Be strong in your personality. Be strong in your content. And then people would love you for that. Some people that are watching this video might just actually want to start influencing. Like, you don't even know different kind of ways you can make money as an influencer, but these are the kinds of ways you can work with clients. So the first is shout out. Shout outs are really, really easy. Shout outs, you can put it in your caption. A shout out, if you have a mailing list, newsletters you send, you can, you know, just talk about a brand in your mailing list, Insta story, in your Facebook post. You can just quickly just drop something about, maybe, oh my gosh, this photography was so amazing, by this person, oh my god, this blouse, oh my god, it's the best thing ever. You get something like that, like just a little shout out to the person you're trying to promote. So you can think about a brand's page, maybe their Instagram, maybe for an event. For example, there was the time I went for one of the London Fashion Weeks back in the day, and I took over Bella Niger's page going there. There was a time MTV Sugar came to do an event in London. I took over Bella Niger's page during the event. So things like that. The next is affiliate marketing. I'm sure we all know affiliate marketing. Affiliate marketing is platforms like RewardStyle, ShopStyle, the most other one I can't remember, you know, I'll put it on the screen. Yeah, so when you link a product to your link and paste it and people buy using that link, you get a commission if they don't return it after 28 days most of the time, or 14 days, but most of the time 28 days. So most of the time when you see us doing whole videos like this, a lot of the links that we put in the description box for you to shop are affiliate links. But we always tell you, like, it's always professional to tell people that come and might get a commission if you don't return this item, something like that. Even when you see on Instagram all the swipe up buy, a lot of times they're obviously trying to help their subscribers, but then again there's a commission involved if, you know, the person doesn't return it. Another way I'll tell you to maximize this is telling your family members, helping people even shop. Even if you're not a personal shopper, maybe you have a friend somewhere else who cannot access shopping online, you just help them do the shopping just so that you can get commissions on platforms that work with the platform you're registered with. I implore people to go on register with RewardStyle. To be honest, they used to be very strict with the way they took in people, but now they're quite open and, you know, very nice to work with. So yeah, RewardStyle is something you should look into if you haven't already. Sponsored post. So sponsored post is just like, yeah, let's say I'm doing this video now and a brand has paid me to, you know, just talk about them. So that's a sponsored post on YouTube. You can also do the same thing on Instagram. You can do the same thing on your blog. You can write a blog post for a brand, just discuss, tell them what they want. They'll give you links to insert into your blog post, and then you do your SEO very well and they pay you. So the next one is gifting. Gifting is the most popular type of influencer way to work. As I'll say, when we're done with this video, I'm going to be unboxing a gift I received from a brand. Even you as a business owner, gifting is also a good way to work. It's just that nobody owes you anything when you just give them. They have to try it and make sure they like it before they even talk about it. Last but not the least is brand ambassador. That encompasses a lot. When a brand actually chooses you to be their brand ambassador, the ambassador is something you have to really think about well, because you probably cannot use any competing brand during a certain period of time. You are the ambassador and you have to embody. Even if for them to have chosen you, they obviously feel you embody what they stand for. So, but being a brand ambassador is something you just think well and be sure, yes, I really want to represent this brand as the ambassador for, so yes. The next thing I'm going to be talking about now are ways you can make money as a content creator or as an influencer. So the first one is sponsorship, which I talked about in the ways you can collaborate. So sponsorships, as I said, you're talking about a brand for at least 1 minute or something if it's a video. So selling your own product doesn't mean you having a product itself. It could be an e-product, it can be an e-book, it can be a preset, it can be so many things, a guide, things people shopping from your affiliate links. Or sometimes some people, even there's no link, they'll just say use this particular code when checking out and they'll know it's you. But those kind of ways are not really transparent because you're not the brand. You won't know how many people use that code. So you should only work that kind of way if you trust the brand you're working with. Donations is another way. Some people have Patreon accounts on YouTube. Some people have PayPal, they just post. Some people have merch. And last but not the least, AdSense. AdSense is obviously, if you're a YouTuber, you know Google's AdSense is the way we make money here. And you can also make money on your blog post with AdSense. Next I'm going to be talking about is how to approach brands as a micro influencer. First of all, you choose a suitable brand. A brand you think, okay, yes, or five, so it mustn't be one. Just choose something choose a brand you think matches with your content. So just try and study the brand and figure out what it is, that how their character or personality is. The next, your pitch. I'm going to make a blog post of ways, emails, templates you can use to send to brands, just so that it helps you. Make sure you're focusing on the collaboration or partnership being a mutually beneficial one. You're not acting like a fan too much, like, oh, you're going to change my life by, you know, partnering with me. At the same time, you're the one looking for them. So just tell them what you can offer. Engage them with their content on social media, wherever it is they are. Just try and drop comments, follow them, understand them better. Just develop a little relationship with them. When you're finally trying to reach out, find emails that are not generic. Go on LinkedIn, find like the marketing person, the content creation person, social media person, you know, target your email properly and use first names of these people, because it will just show that, oh, this person really cares about us. Actually, to find the right email and have your media kit ready. I'm sure by now you have a media kit. Your media kit basically just says what you can offer a brand and how much you charge for those things you can offer a brand. Also, past people you have worked with. If you haven't worked with anybody, fine. Next topic we'll be talking about is how to act when approached by brands. Professionalism, key professionalism. So ask them what their goals are, because some brands are actually just trying to build up an email list. Some are trying to sell. Most of the time they're trying to sell, so they're just trying to put their name out there. Some people just want a lot of people talking about their brand at, you know, a certain time, because that would guide you on how to create whatever you're going to create for them. Ask for if there's a timeline. Just find out what the timeline is. A difficult question I know a lot of people find hard to ask is money. Most blog post people or like banner hanging people, they will tell you a price immediately. At this price, we do no money, and then you can talk. I mean, decent way to ask for money is there a budget for this, or what is this? If they want to use their budget, act like there should be a budget. So you can just ask, what is the budget for this, please? And then they let you know. So that's about it for all the topics I was going to cover today. The last thing I'll say, creativity. There's one thing I noticed about working on paid jobs, there's a pressure that comes with it. Especially when you're newly just starting, because you know, obviously they reach out to you because you're creative, but then again, when you were being creative, you're just doing it at your own free will. There were no rules or anything. But when these people now call me, that we like how you are, we like, you know, do this, you now be wondering, okay, which of my pictures did they like? Which I literally told one lady one time, like, please, which of my posts did you like? She said, no, your entire vibe. I was like, okay, that's the reason why I advise you, do not say no to gifted work. Work on a gifted basis. It kind of strengthens you. It brings out your true, even you get to know yourself better when you're working without the pressure. So it's good practice. Since being a business owner, girls have reached out to me. Like, you see girls, I'll tell you, I would like to style this bag and this bag. Like, can you send it? Or even make it professional. Send you proper Kinida. I would love to. And you go to their page, you see they actually work with real good photographers. So they're actually just trying to build a persona or something. You know, so I don't even, like, it's something you should actually do as an influencer. You see someone you like, you see a product you like, reach out to them. I want to work with you. And then, obviously, when it's not everybody you answer as a business owner, by the time you go and see this person is not even really serious, you look at their comments, there's no buying power in the comments. To be honest, it's not everybody that has 10,000, would I even say 100k followers that have purchasing power. A lot of them are just, hey, slay mama, hey, slay, you slay this today, you slay this tomorrow. There's no money in their pocket to buy your goods. You get, so that's another topic entirely, working with influencers. But yeah, as long as you as a content creator, you know, have a relationship with people, they trust you, you bring something, they'll buy it. That is money for you. Don't joke with your subscribers, don't joke with your tribe, because those are the people that actually help you speak up in public. Another tip I'll be giving you is just talking about your vision, talking about where you want to be, long term, short term. When I cut my hair, I'll put the video somewhere here now. I was just talking about the fact that I wanted to cut my hair. And guys, someone just reached out to me, a salon in London here, that they wanted to bring a black person to the salon for, like, let's say 2 days in a week, and they wanted them to, like, do something to someone's hair. You guys, that's how I should have got my hair cut, like, bleached, colored, cut everything from when it was really long till then. There are other times when I'm just wanting something, I'm just talking about it. Job just comes through that, you know. And then when you're charging this kind of people, you will not even be charging someone, because you know this is something I actually want. Take Femlux, for example. Those ones, I converted them from just free gifting to actually paid work. Ask anybody who has ever worked with Femlux in the UK. It's gifting. It's just that then I was working, I newly started working, their clothes used to be things I could wear to work, you know, so they'll just give you like 3 items, you post them on Instagram, send them the links, and then you can order another 3 again, things like that. But for Femlux, once I place the order, I put the 3 items in my eBay account. Sometimes people even buy it before it comes. Once it comes, I make the shoot, sell off on eBay. So there's so many ways you can actually be smart and strategic when you're still receiving gifts. So I was working with them, I did up to, let's say, 12 posts. Working with Femlux, and at some point I was like, okay, I'm going to actually give these people an invoice. We had a conversation like, okay, do a blog post, and it was, these people were one of the fastest people to pay my invoice. Sometimes you can actually convert just your professionalism, you just putting your energy, praying to God or whoever it is that, you know, guides you divinely. Working hard, working smart as well, seeing what is happening, hashtags. What's the hashtag that they're using to get on the explore page? What is popping people's on products? Engage with other people as well. You know, just be smart with the way you're working. And then you see fruits yield, harvest. Obviously, we know the algorithm changes up and down the whole place. So just keep abreast of things. If you see someone doing masterclass, someone doing information on what's happening right now, listen. Doesn't take anything from you. So that's about it for all the information. I'm going to quickly show you the items I was sent by a brand called Saint and Sophia. Yeah, so they just reached out to me on Instagram. Normally people actually email me and I take them more seriously, but it's not actually DM'd. And I looked at their page, it didn't look bad at all. They actually work with sustainable material, and I was like, okay, cool. So I went into email and started chatting. I picked up the joggers, like 100% soft cotton joggers. I love the details he had here. The other thing I picked was this. I didn't want to pick something that was matchy together. I wanted something I'll be able to wear with different other pieces. Do you get? So I picked this blazer. Yeah, it's navy as well, but the colors are kind of different. And yeah, it's a biker jacket. So I just found it interesting that they had a biker jacket that wasn't leather. It's cloth and stuff. Yeah, this one's £60. So yeah, so they sent it to me and I created content immediately. Like, I literally did the content that same day, I think. But the thing about me, when I finish creating this content, like, especially when I put so much energy, I'll now chill and be waiting. This is almost a week now. I haven't even posted, but I just said I'll quickly do this video and add more value to this video, and then I'll show you some. I'll insert some little bits I created.
For the pair of navy Oxford joggers, I just created content showing different kinds of footwear that could be worn with them. For the navy biker jacket, I paired it with a tulle skirt and then played around with accessories for the hair and footwear as well. I also made a real video for the joggers, that'll be on Instagram, and then cloned myself in pictures. Brands love this, you should learn how to clone yourself in pictures by watching my video in the description box below.
I hope you've taken something from this video. If this is something you loved, enjoyed, and you've gotten to this point of the video, please click the thumb up button if you haven't in the beginning. Share this video with your friends and make sure you come back. Another thing, feel free to ask me questions. I am at Metro Gypsy on Instagram. DM me, send me emails. All my details are in the description box. That's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Stay safe and I'll see you on the next episode. Bye bye.